guys, it's Andrea here. Welcome back to Pet Tunes. In today's video, we will be looking at basic care tips for having a guinea pig as a pet. Their diet. Guinea pigs are herbivores. The most important part of their diet, like rabbits, is grass hay. Grasses are particularly great for guinea pigs because their teeth grow continuously throughout their life, and grass hays are abrasive to the teeth. Grasses also provide a number of nutrients for the guinea pig, as well as both indigestible and digestible fibers. You should avoid legume hays because they are too high in calories, calcium, and protein for your guinea pig. Provide hay in a hay feeder or simply put it in the corner of the cage. Guinea pigs are unable to produce their own vitamin C, much like humans, and therefore need an outside source to avoid developing a disease called scurvy. To prevent this from happening, you should feed your guinea pig fresh fruits and vegetables daily. Dark leafy greens such as kale, collard greens, mustard greens, and dandelion greens are particularly good sources of vitamin C. But you can also try offering sweet peppers, apples, pears, berries, broccoli, cucumbers, parsley, and basil. Of course, it is important for your guinea pig to always have fresh, clean water available to them at all times, either in a zipper bottle or a heavy bowl to prevent spilling. The sight, smell, taste, texture of your guinea pig's food can be mentally stimulating for them, as well as the sound of the food preparation, which can provide a joyful anticipation for what is to come. To increase mental stimulation, you can put hay or fresh foods in empty toilet paper or paper towel rolls, non-toxic baskets, or in little pieces of crumpled paper. You can also put pellets in a small hollow plastic bowl with holes in the side. Guinea pigs can be housed in enclosures made of wire, stainless steel, durable plastic, or glass. There should be one side of the enclosure open to promote air ventilation. It should obviously be escape-proof and have no sharp edges or potential hazards for your guinea pig. Bedding. Must be clean, non-toxic, absorbent, and dust-free. Examples of acceptable bedding include wood shavings, shredded paper, processed ground corn cob, and commercial pellets. The size of your guinea pig enclosure should be approximately 100 square inches of floor area per adult guinea pig. The enclosure can be open on the top, but be sure that the sides are at least 10 inches high so that your pet can't jump out of the cage and cause injury. It is also important to consider any other family pets that may be a threat if the enclosure is open. The environment in which you house your guinea pig should be in a quiet spot away from noise, excitement, and stress. You should avoid direct sunlight as well as cold, damp areas. They are nocturnal, so they need quiet periods of light to rest. Guinea pigs do best in dry, cool environments with adequate ventilation. Guinea pigs are social animals, so more than one can safely be housed together, including males and females. New males may occasionally fight in the presence of a female, but they usually are fine to be together. Older, more dominant guinea pigs may also chew on the ears or hair of their cage mates, so take this into consideration. Handling. Guinea pigs are fairly easy to handle. Placing a hand into the cage will often cause the guinea pig to approach. They can then be easily scooped up. One hand should cup the hind end, while the other hand cradles the midsection. Two hands are always recommended when picking up and handling a guinea pig so that there is less risk of dropping them. They rarely turn aggressive, however, they may jump or try to run if they aren't used to being handled. If you can think of any other care tips for your guinea pig, please let us know in the comment section down below. If you enjoyed today's video, please don't forget to give us a thumbs up, and if you're not already, please consider subscribing by clicking on the button in the middle of your screen. That's it for me today. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.